As someone who's been a nurse for the last 10 years, I can truly say that sitting is the new smoking. It is so vitally important for us to get our bodies moving, to get that cardiovascular system pumping and the lymphatic system moving. Working in the hospital has given me a unique advantage to speak with a lot of people whom I probably would never get the opportunity to speak to. Every day I learn so much about what to do and what not to do. Sometimes I see patients that I consider very young, maybe in their 50s to 70s, and they have so many health problems and they look so much older than they really are. Of course, the opposite is also true. I've had so many times where I've walked into a patient's room and, you know, had to walk back out to make sure I was in the right room because the patient appears much younger than I thought. Or they were just so energetic, I couldn't believe someone this energetic was in their 90s. I've always tried to make it a point to take the opportunity and find out what people's habits are. I like to know the good and the bad, but definitely the good because that's a lot more inspiring. It's really incredible, the human body's potential. It's just so inspiring. I remember when I was a new nurse, I received my very first centenarian. She was 103 years old, and I was actually very upset that I was assigned to her because I was a new nurse. I didn't deserve to have somebody die on my shift. That's, you know, what I was thinking. 103, she must be, you know, taking her last breath as I'm walking into the room. And boy, was I so pleasantly surprised. I walked into the room to find a well-dressed, well-manicured woman, fully clothed, mind you, with hair, makeup, everything done, buzzing around the room with more energy than I could ever have at that hour. And clearly I thought, I'm in the wrong room. So I walked out, and then I was in the right room, so I walked back in. And it was her, and she was 103, fully vital, full of so much energy. And I just had to ask, what do you do? How do you have so much energy? And she, like many others that I have interviewed, works out at least 3 times a week. She does cardio, she lifts weights, she does all kinds of things, and she is not alone. I've spoken to so many people that it really ingrained in my mind that I need to also work out. So I'm going to share with you my workout routine. I do make it a point to work out at least 3 to 7 times a week. The more the better. I just get so addicted to that endorphin rush. It really is special. I start off with 20 minutes of cardio. If I'm home or if I'm around a gym, maybe if I'm in a hotel, I try to get 20 minutes on the elliptical. I love the elliptical because I don't have to keep my eyes open for it. I know I might look a little bit silly, but I don't really care. I love it because I can get such good cardio in and I can actually close my eyes. And so I usually spend the last maybe 10 minutes just with my eyes closed and just visualizing. And I feel like with that incredible endorphin rush and when I'm in that peak state with all those endorphins flowing, it's just the perfect time for me to visualize my future. My cardio is followed then by my yoga routine. I use this opportunity to stretch. While I'm stretching, I visualize myself pushing myself to the max both mentally and physically, as I physically am really pushing myself. Then I top off my workout with a headstand. I hold the headstand as long as I can. While I'm in the headstand, I visualize all the blood flowing to my brain and stretching the blood vessels that are there. I really think that this can help with the elasticity of the blood vessels, although I'm not sure if that's a scientific fact or just a thought. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching. I can't wait to see you in my next video. Talk to you soon. Bye.